What's up, Capsuleers? Today, we are going to be flying a T1 Dark Filament Abyssal Garmer. And how we're going to be doing this is with the following fit. Let me turn down my SoundCloud here. So, my fit is light missiles. Obviously, you would never want rockets on an Abyssal ship. We have a Kaldari Navy small shield booster, which reps 1.6 seconds for 38.2 HPs. Small cap battery 2, 1mn Meta monorepellant at afterburner. We have a small FS9 Regolith compact shield booster. I mean, shield extender, excuse me. 3 BCUs tier 2, 2 processor overclocking units because I have poor engineering skills, and then an NEM screen recorder tier 1. This fit puts out 174 DPS and reps active defenses at 20 HPs a second. The cap is not stable, but if you take control of the small shield booster well, this will not be a problem. I have loaded up 3 runs of filaments, which is 9. You might ask why I have 9 filaments, and that is because each frigate run requires 3 filaments, because you have to open it for a fleet. And so, yeah. Also, when you're doing these, be in a fleet. Let me make sure I am that for a second here. So always form a fleet doing these with a frigate. I see other YouTubers doing frigate videos, but they have pimped out worms, pimped out hawks, all that shit. Well, one doesn't have a pimped out hawk, but he's doing higher tier shit. So we're really going to test how this works. And yeah, but all of them seem to have the pithy... Let me pull it up here. They have the big dead space small shield booster, which is, I'm pretty sure, the B or the A type pithy. These are 140 mil a pop each, depending on which one you get. The Gissies are also 108 mil, but they rep less. These rep 57, but they're still expensive. Do not go for those. Go for the Kaldari Navy. It'll rep you quite nicely. If I go to my simulated fitting and I swap this for a, let's see here, let's say we want a Gissy A type, you're only missing like 8.5 HPs a second. That may be a little bit, that's only a little bit better, right? So, and then the Pithy A type, which is a little bit more expensive. I'm not, you don't have enough CPU in my case, but you get much better stuff. So, obviously, we're going to go with the Kaldari Navy. So, that's our choice, and it's logical, so, and it's much cheaper. So, obviously, the Garmer doesn't have drones, so we don't need to worry about that anyway. Enough blabbering, let's get to it. We are going to be doing it in the system of, let's pick a different system from the last one we did. I'm going to be doing it in, oh boy, let's see. This island, no. I guess we'll go to Jocimento, however you say it. So, I don't need to cover my chats because I'm always on my fleet chat, and it's not like me to check my private chats while doing this, so we're going to be doing that. Alright. And I'll be putting music over this, hopefully, so I don't have to bore you guys out of your goddamn minds. We're gonna go to travel. And we are going to hopefully load the fucking UI. New Kaldari. We're loaded. We're all ready to go. Skarmer's rocking. I will probably cut this part out if I edit it. Alright, we are back. And when you are usually doing this in a system, usually go to a planet. Don't go to a moon, because some people have control towers placed down on those moons. So just go to the planet where the customs office is there, and no one really cares. So let's see if we can deploy this. The structures might be an issue. Nope, no issues. Alright, let's deploy it. Said activate for fleet. Sometimes it doesn't do it. And you go to our UI where you can see the trace and then hit the gate. Alrighty. Time to go into abyssal space. We have a venture going around our trace, which really won't be a big deal if he tries this. Well, actually can't, because what changed with abyssal sites is that you no longer have the suspect status when you go out of the abyssal site. So, an issue. So when we start the site, we're going to immediately turn on our AB. We're going to lock up all the frigates or whatever is in the site, and we start shooting away. Usually, and these are Damvix, so these are the most annoying ones. And how I do my reps is when they get me down to a certain point in my HP. Oh, by the way, I forgot to say we are doing darks. We are doing darks for the reason of fast. You don't need shield regen, you don't need extra resistances, or any of that. So we're doing darks for the speed. So once they start doing a bunch of damage, just wrap for a little bit. And usually these go down quite quickly. They don't do. Do you have enough tank to really? And most of the time they'll miss, but sometimes they will hit. Like that first time that was unlucky. So usually they have enough. Reps, keep circling, and we should take down his armor. I'm probably gonna fast forward this piece and focus. Just relax. These do take a while to take down sometimes. It's quite annoying, honestly. CCP nerfed the Abyssal Damvix. Oh, and I forgot to say, when you are doing these Damvix, as soon as you kill one of them, the others go down like dominoes. Because what happens is they're repping each other. And once you kill one Damovic, the others go down like it's nothing. So just kill one. It'll take a little bit to the first one, but once you get the other ones, they go down like dominoes. I swear to you. Watch this. So I'm gonna let my missiles stop. And then we're gonna shoot this guy. We're gonna keep our shield booster running for a while. This can run for 3 minutes. Just watch your cat. All you have to do is watch your cat. We're repping just fine, so don't worry about it. Don't you worry about it. Actually, I might not speed these forward. Just to show you every little thing I say, every little tip I can give. And don't worry about the difference with running with a Gila and running with a frigate like this, or Garmer, or Hawk, or Worm, is the reload time. Gilas have an insane missile reload time, but most of their DPS comes from their drones. This thing has a way slower fire rate, but also has a much faster reload time, so you don't have to worry about cutting DPS or stuff like that. Which is really good. So if you fit BCUs on your Gila, which you should never fit BCUs on an Abyssal Gila, all DDAs or two DDAs, actually let me show you a fit. So side fit, I'll pay attention. So we go to cruisers, we go to our Gila, and we pull up one of my recent ones. I think this is a PvP fit. Nope, this is an Abyssal fit. So you see that I don't have, I have a free high slot, right? So then I have the AB, I have the three shield extenders. You have the, you can swap these for adaptive invulns. And you can, you see 3DDAs. It has much more DPS. I swear. Put all DDAs or two DDAs, swap your BCs with DDAs on your Gila. Never put BCs on a missile Gila, ever. Just no. And obviously the Purger's extenders mix. And yeah, that's the Gila thing. So I'm gonna get back to this. Sorry if I got my point across too many times there. I just like to make sure you're hearing me. Is I'm going to do the full I'm gonna do the full part for this first room, and if I come up, all of this footage is coming out. I'm gonna stop arguing with myself. Alright. See, this is when you stop your rep, because you keep the Danvik's almost dead, you're fine on shield, and your cap is almost out. So pay attention to your cap. Now I just lock up the cash, check for the juicy shit. Now I have to push the wreck and stop my AB because it's just annoying. We go to cargo, we go to missiles while we can, grab everything in the can, and we'll get the go. Actually, just okay, I need to use that more. The little, what's it called? Whatever this is. Got all the loot we needed in that room. We never got the extraction nodes because they're shit, T1s. So we have Teslas in this room, which are not a big deal here than the Danviks. These go down much faster, although there are more of them. So yeah, let's just get rid of these. What we're gonna do, oh my god, that's actually a fuck ton of damage. Because they all hit me. Usually they don't hit me like that. That was fucking crazy. Whoa. That was like shocking. They have never hit me that hard before. So just be careful of that in Tesla rooms. They most of the time miss, but yeah, see, like they'll have those chains of damage. Just keep your shield booster running when those come up. The more you kill, the more the faster DPS goes away. So while you're killing the first few, just have your shield booster up. That's something. But most of the time they will miss you. Just sometimes they do. Just be careful of that. That's where they kill that first one. We shoot the can last. And that was actually a really good hit. I don't know why it hit that hard. No idea why. Oh, probably because they're really close. Maybe that's better. Maybe don't open the fire or get a 500 damage weapon. So, some rooms, they're gonna have situations where you have to orbit at a different distance than you normally would think. Like this case, where I had to move my orbit. Or maybe they're just faster. In this case, I would just let your shield suffer for a bit after quite a bit of using the cap. So we just let the cap regen. Do not let your shield get to a point where it's like deadly low, like past 1/3 shield. Don't let it go beyond below that. So yeah. My guy was literally in 1%. So we have all of them locked up. Almost done with these. Some of these just go down really quick. See, the one that's really close is the one that's like in me. So, see, this is when, right here, when your cap is really good and it stops your charging for a little bit, starts your charging a little bit slower, that's when you start using the resistor again, just to keep it up. Also, if we get a battleship room, that should be really easy. Breeze through those rooms. If you get hit by the battleship, burst the battleship, you're fucked. If you get hit by a V-Chef, you can take one hit, but that's it. I'm pretty sure you're fucked if you get hit by a Drifter, because those things can obliterate people's shields. I mean, their alpha is ridiculous, so... with good resistances, their alpha is still ridiculous, so... do not get hit by a Drifter, you will get fucked. I swear, your EHP on this frigate is just nothing compared to what the alpha of the Drifter Battleship can do. Royal cash, go to loot. Stop our AB, stop our shield booster. So databases, or boot, or you could call it red boot, whatever. Okay, last room. We will reload our missiles when we get a chance. Look at that, right. So, this is the Drifter Battleship. What you do in this case is we are going to orbit the thing, the world permanent AB. We will not need to activate our shields, as the electric are not going to hit us. Your locking range, for me at least, is like 35%. So, see, he's really weak because whatever the fuck region they're weakening. I think these things just come out of bounds and shit, so just fucking fire on it. If he goes away, follow him. If he goes over the area where you're not supposed to go, like the Abyss of Depths, you go near the Abyss of Depths, be super duper careful not to go past the red barrier, as you will take damage if you do go past that red barrier. And we're gonna lock the cache just in case we get this done really fast. And it looks that. Look at that. He's literally going away. Just be super duper careful. Actually, don't approach. We're gonna orbit him at. Is it 10? We already popped the cache on accident, so. Be super careful. This thing will go to the edge. And it's kind of a bug. It shouldn't be going to the edge, but if you do get close to the edge, approach the wreck. Like that. Just approach the wreck. Shit. Just approach the fucking gate or whatever. Just be really careful not to go outside of the abyssal area that you're not supposed to go past. As we leave, we're gonna hit him one more time and then he's dead. So just approach the wreck, open it, and you'll be off. This is the last room, so you have accomplished your first, or whatever time you've done this abyssal thing in a fragment. I mean, in a ship. A frigate. If I could stop being dyslexic. Okay, we are going to open this. We have a ton of loot. good amount of loot in there. So take that. Got about 7 million from the site. I really want to do T2s, but I'm not sure if I trust them, because T2s are awful hard. Might need better tank for the T2s. Although T2s are much better rewards. Although I did get a Destroyer skill book out of AT1 just today. So that was awesome. I sold that for 140 million. So the T1s can pull stuff. I mean, I pulled 20 mil on another site. And yeah, so they're good. It's just, you gotta. Oh, and here's a tip. Complete the site. Go up to another planet. We can do another one. Like we are. There is a guy with suspect status in here. Also, there's a guy with terrorist status in here. Let's open the next filament. We're going to continue doing this until we get our last one done. So I'm just proving you this works and that this ship is very, very effective at what it does.
If you go out, you come back.
Alright, it looks like we have a room
and you come back
with what seems to be a Lancer and a battleship. So in this case, I'm pretty sure the battleship doesn't go to the edge of the map with this particular spawn.
In case you do,
I'm going to be ready.
Dumped in the
32 kilometers, okay.
And there's nobody there.
And the Lancer will hit you, but eliminate the battleship first. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Like, comment, subscribe. LX out. Yeah.